Hello friends, we welcome to Legal Breeze. Today we will be talking about whether right to internet or right to access to internet is a fundamental right or not. Certainly, it is a fundamental right. It has been recently upheld by our Honorable Supreme Court of India in a case in 2020. Prior to that, we have good number of cases like you all know when Article 370 has been abrogated. The whole gamut of internet and internet-based services has been totally suspended in the state of Jammu and Kashmir is concerned. It has continued more than 200 plus days. What a misery it is. There is a prominent MP, I think is a Congress leader, Ghulam Nabi Azad, and another person has also made a petition before the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has clubbed both petitions together and ruled that it should be restored. Accordingly, 2G services have been restored. Later on, Media Foundation has again filed a petition before the Honorable Supreme Court. Thereafter, 3G, 4G services have been partially restored to Jammu and Kashmir. Now, the suspension of the internet is not affecting merely freedom of expression. It affects various other fundamental rights, such as right to health, right to education, right to food, and many more things. So whatever the concept, quote unquote, reasonable restrictions embedded under Article 19, or to some extent there are certain procedural safeguards established under Article 21, will not be applicable to the right to access to internet. This is what my humble opinion is. The constitutions are being made which are suited only to the analogous era or analogous age. It may not be suited in the same version to the digital age. Say example, there is a prohibition, complete prohibition to unlawful search and seizure under the 4th Amendment in the US Constitution. Now, if the GPS is installed at your mobile phone or at your vehicle or at your home, something like that, it is an intrusion into your privacy. And if it is done unlawfully or without lawful grounds, they say it is an illegal search and seizure. So such a great dynamic wider interpretation has been made by the Supreme Court of US in a case called US versus Jones, something like that. US versus Jones. So we need to evolve such a greater standards. The standards, the procedural safeguards established under Article 21, as well as the quote unquote reasonable restrictions imposed under Article 19, to my humble understanding, may not be applicable to the right to access to internet. For the simple reason, right to access to internet is not affecting one particular right or set of rights. It affects the whole gamut of rights, such as right to food. Say example, without internet today, I cannot order the food items, not only food items, the direct food itself. Because you are getting foods to be delivered at your home through various apps. This has become more problematic during the corona times actually. Because you cannot move physically, you need to get the food stuff. Hotels are not that much available. So you need to depend upon internet. On the other hand, digital payments, either for your education, for basic amenities like having a telephone, power bill, everything you need to depend upon digital payment system. And your right to education, people have to learn only through internet. There is no other alternate during the COVID times. Apart from that, right to health, because it provides you telemedicine services also. Without internet, you can't get all these services. This is very, very important. So it affects right to health, right to education, right to freedom of expression, and right to do your trade and business also. Because many businesses have been rooted through internet after the COVID. So when it affects the whole gamut of rights, I am afraid whether the reasonable restrictions imposed upon under Article 19 and the procedural safeguards made available under Article 21 will be sufficient to curtail the rights of right to access to internet. We need to evolve a new standards so as to protect the right to access to internet. Say example, if you are cutting the power on the name of security of state or friendly relations or any other thing, without power supply today, it is will be, though it is not impossible, it will be highly impracticable to lead a dignified life today as it has been granted under or guaranteed under Article 21. So we believe strongly that the Supreme Court of India will come up with new set of standards like it has evolved in the Menaka Gandhi case, that the procedure established by law should not be mere procedure by established by law. It should be reasonable, fair and just, elevating to the due process status. We hope such a new evolution will take place so as to protect the rights of the citizens as well as non-citizens. Otherwise, Article 69A has to be examined on other grounds also, because it has got a narrowed escape in Shreya Singhal case. The court has believed that there are certain reasonable safeguards made available under Section 69A of Information Technology Act. The recent revelation, the recent dispute between the government of India and the Twitter clearly shows that the government has clearly failed to perform its obligations. Particularly, it has failed to comply Article 14, because government cannot give an order unilaterally. There shall be a recent order, and that reason shall be communicated as per the decision of the Supreme Court in Shreya Singhal case. And the same has been reiterated in the Kashmir internet cases also. When you are blocking the internet, people should know why are you blocking the internet. What is the reasons for that? And the another basic principle, basic tenet, or what is called audi altum partum. You should hear the other party before you are imposing such a blanket ban. I'm afraid such a procedure, such a basic rights or principles of natural justice per se has been violated by our government of India in the Twitter case. That is what we are learning. I may be wrong, but this is what we are hearing actually. So Twitter has to go to the court and to see that its rights getting established, and it's not only protecting the rights of the Twitter, its right of doing trade and business under Article 19, but other rights like industry, trade and commerce protected under Article 301 to 307. It will also strengthen the rights of the citizens. This is very, very important. And there shall be a third party arbitrator. There shall be a tribunal which should decide if whether the blocking order given by the court is right or not before it is being implemented. Such a safeguard must be necessary, because the government has failed to carry out its obligations as it has been legitimately expected by the Supreme Court. Once it is proven that the government is not complying, I think the Supreme Court will come out with certain newer safeguards so as to protect the rights of the citizens. We hope such a day will come sooner rather than later. God bless you all. Jai Hind. Thank you.